Hello and welcome to Market Secrets Option Trading Series, which is based on monthly income strategies. Today we are going to see episode 1, which is on credit spreads. We'll call it as monthly income strategy because it is not like regular trading strategies. This strategy can be used to generate a regular income month after month by following the exact same steps. And the chances for hitting the loss is extremely low because odds are highly in our favor. So with that being said, let's move to the disclaimer plot. The views expressed in the video are for informational purposes only and do not constitute to be of any investment, legal or taxation advice. They are not indicative of the future market trends, nor is to predict the same. Republishing any part of this video will be at your own risk, and we at Market Secrets will not be liable for consequences of any such action. If you have any queries or if you want to know more about us, you can reach us at our website, which is marketsecrets.in. So before we open today's session, we would like to add one more item here. We have already conducted multiple trainings on option basics and every single element of option basics. And this series is purely for advanced option training. And this is based on the request that I have received from you folks personally. So if you have any concerns or doubts on any of the option basics, please do let me know in the comment section of this video. I'll try to come up with separate video on those as well. Also, whenever you trade options, you need to have clarity on how a stock would move. Only then you'll be able to trade on options. For that purpose, you can use our monthly level file to predict how a stock would move till this expiry. So I'll leave the link to monthly level file in the description section of the video, along with the link to the video where I have explained how to use the monthly level file. Also, I would leave the link to previous option sessions as well. So go through it, and if you have any clarity, feel free to reach me through the comment section of this particular video. With that being said, let's begin today's session, which is on credit spreads. So we are going to take an example of put side. You can even do the same thing on the call side. Credit spreads is a two-leg strategy, which indicates we'll be using two option contracts to take up this trade. And it is a net credit strategy, which indicates we'll be collecting the premium while taking the trade. We'll explain about this in detail in a short while. And you'll have to sell higher strike PE and you'll have to buy lower strike PE. And in this case, your risk is limited and your profit is also limited. Your max loss and max profit, everything you will know even before taking up the trade, and you will have to understand the break-even point as well. So to understand this, let's have a look at our payoff diagram for credit spread. So if you look at the payoff diagram, if the stock price stays above a particular value, even if it goes to infinity, even then your profit is going to be the same. But if the stock is going to go down below this particular value, then it will indicate a loss for you. And once it breaches a specific value, your loss will remain the same. So both your upside and downside is capped. That is the beauty of this particular strategy. So let's have a look at an example, which is on Allahabad Bank. So I have Allahabad Bank daily chart here, and Allahabad has been moving between 35 and 50 for a long time now. It has been range bound for almost 3 months now. Let's have a look at OI data of Allahabad Bank as well. The current price of Allahabad is 40.7, and if you apply the technique that I have taught you in the options basics training, then you would see your OI resistance is at 45 and your OI support is at 40. Since I am going to take credit spread puts, I need to take two strike prices below the current market price. So I am selecting 37.5 PE and 35 PE. Okay, so this is how the trade will pan out. It's a two-leg strategy. My first leg is 37.5 put and second leg is 35 put. And it is a net credit strategy, so I'll be collecting the premium. So the premium that I am going to collect is, I'll be collecting 0.30 by selling 37.5 puts, because that is the last traded price of 37.5 PE. And I'll have to pay 0.15 points for buying 35 put. So if you look at the last traded price of 35 put, it's 0.15. And if you look at the net premium collected, it will be 0.15. So this is called the net credit. 0.15 points is my net credit. And I'll be selling the highest strike P and buying the lowest strike P. So I'll sell 37.5 P and I'll buy 35 P. So the risk here is limited and the profit is limited as well. So if you look at here, my max profit is the net premium received. So which is 0.15 points. So if you consider lot size as 10,000, then your max profit is 0.15 into 10,000, which is 1,500 rupees. And I will get the maximum profit if the price stays above the shorted put strike price, which is 37.5. And I will get the maximum loss if the price of the stock goes below 35 rupees. And my maximum loss would be 23,500 rupees. So you can use this formula to arrive at the maximum loss for any of the stock. I know about the risk reward ratio. I know you have that particular question in your mind, but if you have attended my option basics training, then you would have known what I mean here. We always go with odds, then R&R. So I'll leave the link to that particular video in the description section of this video. And the last item is a break-even point, and you have the formula for the same here. And my break-even point for this particular trade is 37.35. So if the stock expires at 37.35, then I don't have any profit or loss. It will be at zero. If the stock expires somewhere in between 35 and 37.5, then in such cases, my profit or loss would be between 1,500 to 23,500. So that is how it pans out. So this is a very, very simple strategy, but very, very effective strategy as well. And you can use it on any of the stocks, or you can even use it in Bank Nifty weekly expiry trades. But only thing that is needed is practice. You need to put in a lot of practice to understand how this trade pans out in the real time. So the example that I have shown here is just an example. You don't have to take this particular trade directly because the liquidity in Allahabad Bank is extremely low. So if you have any queries or concerns, please do leave it in the comment section of the video. And if you need training on any of the basic items separately, feel free to mention that as well. If you have liked the video, hit the like button. If you find it worthy, please do share it with your friends. Also, please do subscribe to the channel so that you'll get notified whenever we conduct live sessions. So if you would like to know more about us, you can visit our website. Also, if you would like to receive daily market updates from us, you can join our Telegram channel. I'll leave the link to all these in the description section of the video as well. Thanks again for watching. Have a great day. Goodbye.